Obviously coming back for season 8, I have lost my top dog role. And I don't like it. I kind of enjoyed being top dog.
And what we're coming out of is the end of season 7, which was the siege, which was probably the biggest sequence that we have ever attempted on Wentworth as a series whole.
Even though you know you're acting, it's still horrifying to have a gun pointed at you.
Like, I didn't kill them myself, but I understand why some of them have died because of the siege.
Mari is not one of Linda's favourite people. In fact, Mari is not anybody's favourite person.
I feel like I didn't pull the trigger myself, but hey, I know. Look, put it this way, I'm not the most liked inmate at present.
There's a mixed feeling because Liz isn't with us anymore and Kaz, so you can feel their absence and you have new people coming in, which I'm sure that's Wentworth and that's prison.
I mean, Susie Porter's just brilliant. I mean, I'd watch her looking at a wall for an hour and she'd make that interesting.
Mari will have to adapt in another way to stay alive.
We're rewriting the scripts and Mari and Ruby become lovers. Is that mean?
Yeah. And have some kids.
Sucked in, Ali.
Oh, yeah.
Dump both of us.
Yeah, Ali, you've become too hard.
Yeah, Ali.
You were once a really nice girl.
I know. She was good to us at one point. Did she used to get me chocolate? Did she used to get me chocolate?
More than chocolate, if you catch my drift. But
what this show does brilliantly is give characters a scope for redemption. And I think that even though a character like Mari, who could seem irredeemable, the writers have a brilliant way of finding redemption in sometimes the most irredeemable characters.
It's going to be a lot of fun to see what she does with Mari. I'm not telling you anything because it's all secret. Anne and Mari do have, yes, some contact, good contact.